Hello everyone. Our effort in AC circuit analysis so far has been focused mainly on calculating voltage and current. However, now our major concern in this part of course is power analysis. So now I am going to focus on power analysis. And we have already understand the meaning of analysis. Analysis means either we are going to calculate the power absorbed by some element or power delivered by some element. So it means that power absorbed or power delivered by some element of the circuit. And in this part of this course we are mainly focused on AC circuit, so we are going to talk about the AC circuit. So we are going to talk about the AC circuits. So there are several terminology associated with this power analysis. We begin by considering two different quantity. So first one is called instantaneous power, and second one is called average power. So in this lecture we are going to understand the concept of instantaneous power as well as average power. So if you see the instantaneous power, it is the product of the time domain voltage and the time domain current associated with the element of network of interest. So if you have to calculate the instantaneous power, then you can select any element of the network or circuit, and after that you can calculate the voltage across that particular element or current through that particular element and just take the product. That is the meaning of instantaneous power. I will come to the formal definition of this in the later part of this class. Now main concern is that why basically we are bothered about the instantaneous power. And one of the most important point is the safety of our device, or you can also write the following thing: safe operating range of physical device. This is the one of the important concern during the electrical circuit analysis, and somehow this can be ensured using the calculation of instantaneous power. So I'm going to change the color. The instantaneous power is sometime quite useful in its own right, because it maximum value have to limited to avoid exceeding the safe operating range of any physical device. So you may have seen that most of device is operated based on the electrical power. So somehow by seeing the maximum value of instantaneous power, and we have already understand that instantaneous power is nothing but that is the product of voltage across and current through that particular element. So we will just see the maximum value of that, and after that I am going to make sure that that value is not going to exceed this safe operating range of the physical device. So due to that reason, the instantaneous power calculation of instantaneous power has very important in the case of physical device. So let us take example. So using example, I think that you are able to understand in more proper way. So for example, suppose you have some transistor or vacuum tube, power amplifiers, both produce a distorted output, and speakers give a distorted sound when the peak power exceeds a certain limiting value. So in this way you are able to check that whatever device which is in front of you, their operating range is proper or not. Because if the instantaneous power exceed the safe operating range, then device output has some kind of certain kind of distortion. So by seeing the distortion, I can interpret that without any calculation that instantaneous power or maximum value of instantaneous power that is going to exceed the safe operating range of the physical device. So this is the first region to study about the instantaneous power. Second one is more important, somehow that is concerned with the measurement. So however, we are mainly interested in instantaneous power for the simple reason that it provides us with the means to calculate a more important quantity, and name of that quantity is the average power. So once one can calculate the instantaneous power, based on that it is possible to show that how to calculate the average power. That is the another importance of the calculation of instantaneous power in any electrical circuit or network. And I have already discussed this point, that same like classical physics, we are talking about the instantaneous velocity and average velocity. So suppose that you are planning to go for a long trip. So most of time we are just concentrated on the average velocity. However, suppose that you are driving your car on the highway, at that time we have to concentrate on the instantaneous velocity also, in order to make sure that you are out of danger. Means suppose that in some particular highway a speed limitation is not more than 120 km per hour. So instantaneous velocity gives us information that the velocity of our car is not more than 120 kilometers. And average velocity makes sure that how much time it requires to reach certain destination. So similar kind of things also here, two different kind of quantity. One is instantaneous power and another is average power. So our during measurement we are using instantaneous power to make sure that some device or some electrical device is operating on the safe zone and using average power, we are going to make sure the another type of quantity or somehow some kind of calculation that how much cost we have to pay or something like that. So in practical problems, we will deal with the value of average power, and this average power is range from picowatt to billions of watts. So if you see the practical example, it is try to understand that where picowatt power is required, where billions of power is required. So I'm going to write a note. In practical problems, we will deal with value of average power, which range from the a small fraction of a pico watt power available in a telemetry signal from the outer space. So here you can see that I have very small amount of power. We are getting those kind of signal whenever we try to observe the signal either coming or going from the base station to the outer sphere or outer sphere to the base station. And similarly to the few watts of audio power supplied to the speakers in a good stereo system. So now you can see that in first example, I need just the picowatt of the power. In second example, I need few watts. Similarly, in third example, now to the several 100 watts required to run the morning coffee pot. So here again you can see that now I am shifting from few watts to 100 watts, and or to the 100 billion watts generated at the dam. So whenever we are dealing with either DC or AC, at that time our range of power is very very large. We are start from picowatt to billions of the watt. And I have already discussed that whenever it comes that I have to measure some quantity, then it is better or it is somehow easy to calculate the average. Why? Because our instrument has certain time to do calculation. So suppose that I have to calculate some quantity between T1 to T2, then it is easy, rather than it is to calculate this some quantity at exactly at T. And due to that reason, most of device is based on the calculation of the average power. So let us now start the formal definition of these two, means instantaneous power as well as average power, because now we have understood the approximate meaning of these two. So let us start with the instantaneous power. So I am going to start with the formal definition. So definition of instantaneous power: the instantaneous power is the power in, we are going to calculate in watts, absorbed by the element at a specific instant of time, and somehow it is motivated from the physics, that is instantaneous velocity. You can also tell. So basically PT is VT multiplied by IT. Where VT is the instantaneous voltage across the element and IT is the instantaneous current through it. So in this way we are defining the instantaneous power. So now let us try to see the power due to sinusoidal excitation, because I have already discussed that the main motivation or main concern of this part of course is the AC power, and we have already seen how to calculate the DC power in the previous part of this course. So due to that reason, now I am going to consider the power due to sinusoidal, because I am going to model the AC excitation source by sinusoidal, means either in form of sine or cosine. So excitation, so basically I am going to talk about the more general expression of the power. So now consider the general case of instantaneous power. Instantaneous power absorbed by an arbitrary combination of circuit element under sinusoidal excitation. So let us try to see the same kind of thing through the block diagram. So basically my concern is like this. Suppose that I have some kind of sinusoidal sources, so I am going to put that source inside this black box. And suppose this source is going to delivered some kind of power to this particular network, and here I have sinusoidal source, so current is going to enter inside this another black box. And suppose that I have this VT, and inside this box I have passive linear network, means combination of resistor, capacitor and inductor network. we have already seen in the previous classes that if network is linear, then form of external excitation and form of the output is exactly same, only magnitude is going to alter based on the element of passive network, and also we have some addition or subtraction of the phase. So same kind of things I am going to write here. Let the voltage and current at the terminals of the circuit be so. If I assume that Vt that is of this form, of cosine form, where angular frequency is omega and phase is theta v, so whatever current, so current of this form, so I am, so these two quantity magnitude is different, but whatever response, that is exactly the same. I am assuming that due to this Vt, It current is generated in the passive linear network. So form remains the same. In several class I have discussed about these two. And in this particular thing where Vm and Im are amplitude and theta v and theta I, are the phase angles of the voltage and current respectively. And once we will identify the current and voltage across any element, then from the previous definition I can calculate the instantaneous power. So the instantaneous power absorbed by the circuit is Pt equal to Vt multiplied by It, and that is Vm Im cos omega t plus theta v multiplied by cos omega t plus theta I, and here you can see that I have cos A and cos B of this form. So I am going to apply the trigonometric identity. So I can write that cos A into cos B equal to half cos A minus B plus cos A plus B from the trigonometric identity. So this is the trigonometric identity, and we have already learned about several identity related to this. And so just you can substitute here. So I have this quantity, so I am going to apply this kind of identity here. So after applying this identity, one can write PT, that is instantaneous power, that is half Vm Im cos theta V theta I, and after that I have half Vm Im cos 2 omega t theta V plus theta I. So here you can see that I have basically two terms now, and I have this term and this term. So if you see the first term, this term is constant because that is not depending on time. Vm and Im are the magnitude, maximum magnitude, and theta V and theta I are the phase difference of the phase angle. So this is constant, or I can also write that independent of time, independent, and it is only going to depends on phase difference between the instantaneous voltage and the instantaneous current. Now let us try to understand the interpretation of second part. So if you see the second part, so second part is the sinusoidal function. So and if you see the frequency, now here frequency doesn't remains the same like the exciting voltage or current. So what we have observed in the case of linear passive network, if I will apply some kind of voltage and whatever current that is going to generate, so frequency of the applied voltage and generated current remains the same. But that is no longer true in case of instantaneous power. You can see that in second term, whatever frequency we are observing here, that is the two times. So this particular term is basically 2 multiplied by the original frequency of the signal. So same kind of things I am going to highlight here. So the second part is sinusoidal function. So form of response remains the same. Sinusoidal frequency function, and here you can write whose frequency is 2 omega which is twice the angular frequency of voltage or current. So that is the some modification in frequency if we are considering the instantaneous power absorbed by some passive network. One can also observe one of the important thing, and that important thing I am going to write here. So our, you can write in form of remarks. We observe that PT is again periodic, because I can write PT equal to PT plus T0. And has a period of T0 equal to T by 2, where T is 2 pi by omega, and this is a standard. We know that how to calculate the T whenever I have angular frequency. And we observe that PT is the period and has a period of this, and why I am telling period is T0 equal to T by 2, since its frequency is twice that of voltage current. So due to that reason, we are telling that T0 is half of the original period of the voltage or current. Frequency is twice. Due to that reason, T become half. That is the reason. Now let us try to see the sketch of PT versus time. So now I am going to plot the sketch. So I am going to select two axes. So here I have, this is power and this is the time. And if you see the response of the power, so basically power response has two terms, one constant term and after that another is sinusoidal function. And suppose that if you have to plot these kind of graph, so you have already learned during your 10 plus 2 that whenever you have to plot something which is varying with time plus some constant quantity, so first you can plot the time varying quantity and after that just you can shift that quantity, basically vertical shift occur by the constant quantity. So here my response is looks like cosine wave and that is shifted by this particular constant term 1 by 2 Vm Im cos theta V plus theta I. So let us draw this wave form. So I have some shift. So let us suppose this is the shift and after that I am going to plot the main signal. So main signal it looks like this. So I have some cosine wave like this and something like this. So this is just an approximate plot. Now try to see here that this I have to shift. So this particular shift is half Vm Im cos theta V minus theta I, that is equal to that particular constant term, and this the maximum magnitude from this line is half Vm and Im. So this is approximate plot, but exact plot will not, somehow I am not able to plot good one, but it, for understanding you can understand this is the cosine wave and which has magnitude equal to half Vm into Im, and after that wave is basically shifted by this particular constant unit, that is the meaning of this figure. So now let us try to see some more interpretation. So basically this figure is the instantaneous power PT entering a circuit. From this plot I will get some observation, and that is the one of the most important observation. You can see that at some time PT is positive and sometime it is negative. So what is meaning of the positive power and negative power. So I am going to now interpret. So our observation is basically observation. So observation is looks like this. PT is positive for some part of each cycle. It means that since this signal is periodic, so and period of this is t by 2, so suppose that this particular time is t by 2. Similarly, there exist, so I have to extend this axis. So here somewhere I have t. So each cycle and also negative. So in if I am considering cycle from 0 to t by 2, so you can see that somewhere it is positive and negative for the rest. Negative for the rest of the cycle. So that is our direct observation. Now I am going to correlate this observation with these two points. So when PT is positive, power is absorbed by the circuit. And let us try to interpret the negative one. When PT is negative, power is absorbed by the source . So whenever we are telling that power is absorbed by the source, somehow we are telling that power is transformed from the circuit to the source. So power is transformed from the circuit to source. And this is possible only when if the storage elements are capacitor or inductor. So let us talk about the possibility also. So this is possible because of the storage element . Because I have considered the generalized passive network and inductors. And same kind of information is basically reflected during the power calculation, that some energy or some power, sorry, some power is positive, some power is negative. So I have positive and I have negative. So this is the story about the instantaneous power. So what we have observed, that instantaneous power has straightforward interpretation, that just that is the multiplication of instantaneous value of the current and voltage across some particular element. And if you see the whole network, then power may be positive and negative in the case of the sinusoidal excitation of the linear network. And we have observed the interpretation, what is meaning of the positive power, what is meaning of the negative power. Now let us talk the difficulty of the instantaneous power. So difficulty, what kind of difficulty we are facing during, so this is once we define some quantity, then second more important aspect comes into picture, that is related to measurement. Is it possible to measure some quantity easily or not? So main difficulty here is like this. So difficulty is that the instantaneous power changes with time. We have already seen that I have constant term plus some another term, second term, that is changing with respect to time. And is therefore difficult to measure. So if some quantity is changing regularly with time, then it is very difficult to measure, and at that time we have to specify the measuring time. These kind of things that become very crucial. Sometime it might possible that whatever measurement that is done by you and your friend, that is different because of the different time frame. So due to that reason, this kind of difficulty we are facing during the measurement of the instantaneous power. And due to this reason, some more relevant quantity comes into picture, and let us define that quantity. So next definition, that is nothing but the average power, that is the motivation to define average power. So let us first see the formal definition, and after that I will discuss more about it. So average power, so the average power, again I am going to measure this average power in the same unit, that is in watts, is the average of the instantaneous power over a period, means T by 2. And we will discuss little more about this, why I am only taking the average over a period. And we have already understand the motivation, and motivation of defining the average quantity is like this: the average power is more convenient average power is more convenient to measure in fact the wattmeter, that is one of the instrument to measure the power. The instrument for measuring power responds to average power. It means that whenever you are using watt meter, you are not measuring the instantaneous power. Basically, you are talking about the average power. So let us talk about what is meaning of the average power in general. So whenever we are talking about this quantity, that is the average power, so when we speak of an average value of the instantaneous power, the time interval over which the averaging process takes place must be clearly identified or clearly defined. And during the definition, you may have noticed that I was talking about the average of the instantaneous power over a period. So I have specified the time interval. So suppose that I have to calculate the average of any general quantity. So at that time, first step is that let us first select a general interval of time from T1 to T2. We may then obtain the average value by integrating PT from T1 to T2 and dividing the result interval T2 minus T1, and thus I can write the average power, that is P is 1 by T2 minus T1, and that is integration from T1 to T2 and PT into DT. And in our case, you can see that our signal is periodic. So now I have little more specific case, that is average power for a periodic waveforms. So whatever instantaneous power we are getting in case of sinusoidal excitation, that is periodic. So now you can take any periodic waveform, either that is of sinusoid in nature or not, that doesn't matter, but result remains the same, whatever result I am going to state now. So suppose that I am going to consider some kind of waveform, obviously that is periodic, and I have this kind of plot. Suppose that I am going to plot like this. Something like this. Or now I have to maintain the periodicity, so I have to become more careful about the nature. So again I am going to see something like this, and similar kind of things. I assume that that is going to repeat here. So now you can see that if I have some kind of periodic waveform, and for generalization I am not going to take only sinusoid. So here if you select two time interval, this is T1, and suppose next one I am going to select, that is TX, and if we are telling that this is periodic. So if I scale T1 to T1 plus T, then again I am going to get the same waveform. So let us try to see that somehow I am talking about these waveform. So that is T1 plus T, and second point is TX plus T. So now either you can calculate the power at this particular instant or average value of this, or here. So basically I am going to write like this. P1, that is the 1 by T, and that is T1 plus T1 plus T, and this is PT into DT. So basically T2 instant I have selected like this, that is T1 plus T, or in general you can talk about this 1 by T, and that is TX, and here TX plus T, and again I have PT into DT. So basically P1 and PX both are exactly the same. So here I have basically this is TX. So I will write it clearly. So I have this quantity like TX. So what is main interpretation comes into picture from this particular figure, that thus the average power may be computed by integrating the instantaneous power over any interval. But just I have to make sure that interval, that is 1 period in length and thus dividing by the period, whatever period we have considered. So now from here you can see that you have start one experiment related to power measurement. Suppose if you start at 5 o'clock in evening, and if your friend is started at 6 o'clock in the evening, but whatever reading you are getting at 5:30 and your friend is getting at 5:30, both are exactly the same. So we have to just worry about the time interval, and due to that reason people are interested in the average power, because initial selection of time doesn't alter the magnitude of the power calculation. So almost all measurement techniques are based on this average power. Now let us try to come to the mathematical calculation and some more interpretation related to the average power. So now I am going to discuss, that is average power in the sinusoidal steady state. And we already calculated the instantaneous power in case of sinusoidal steady state. So just we have to integrate that quantity for time interval for a period of t equal to t0 by 2. So And after that, we have already seen that either you can integrate up to some more larger interval than a period, result remains the same. Thus, I can write like this. Thus, the average power is given by P equal to 1 by T and 0 to T PT into DT. So for convenient, I am denoting average power by capital P or instantaneous power by small p. So let us see the although equation 1 shows the averaging done over T, we would get the same result if we perform the integration over the actual period of PT, which is T0 equal to T/2. So either you can interpret up to actual period T0 or original period of the exciting voltage or current, the average power remains the same. And this is obvious from the previous interpretation. So now let us substitute the instantaneous power in equation first and try to calculate the average power. So now I am going to substituting PT, and this gives average value of power, that is, again I am going to do integration. So first term, that is constant one, I am cos theta v minus theta I into dt, and after that I have the second term, that is the half Vm Im cos 2 omega t plus theta v plus theta I into dt. So basically I have half, if you manipulate the first term, then I will get Im cos theta v minus theta I, and second term is half Vm Im, and I have 1 by t here, and integration from 0 to t, and here I have cos 2 omega t plus theta v theta v plus theta I into dt. So I have basically two terms, and here again this term is constant, and second term, that is sinusoid. And one more important quantity here, that you can see the second term very carefully, that is of the form of cosine, and we know that the average of a sinusoid over its period is zero, because the area under sinusoid during a positive half cycle is cancelled by the area under its during the following negative half circle. So if you calculate this integration, so that is going to vanish. So mean value of second term equal to zero. So thus the second term vanishes, and the average power becomes, and if you write the expression of average power, that is now half Vm Im cos theta v minus theta I. So you can see that average power is no longer depends on the time. So due to that reason, we have no need to worry about the time. We have to just worry about the phase difference between the voltage and the current. So, and another more important observation is like this. Since cos theta v minus theta I is exactly equal to cos theta I minus theta v, so what is important is the difference in the phases of the voltage and current. So either you can do theta V minus theta I or theta I minus theta V, that doesn't matter. So, and another observation I have already discussed, so it is very important remark that PT is time varying. So PT is instantaneous power, is time varying, while average power, that I am going to denote by P, does not depend on time. So this is one of the important observation. Now let us try to discuss some more point. And the point is related to the calculation of the both powers. So to find the instantaneous power, we must necessarily have Vt and It in the time domain, because we have already seen that the instantaneous power is nothing but the multiplication of instantaneous voltage and instantaneous current. And in order to calculate the average one, now I have flexibility, so I am going to talk about that flexibility. However, we can find the average power when voltage and current are expressed in time domain or when they are expressed in frequency domain, means with help of the phasor. So in or frequency domain. So now in order to calculate the average power, I can use the both domain. So let us try to see that how to use the frequency domain. So next part of today's discussion on based on that only. So I am going to talk about the average power in frequency domain. So In order to talk about the frequency domain, I have to express the voltage as well as current in form of phasor. So the phasor form of Vt and It, and that is Vm. So we are actually just collecting the magnitude and phase. Similarly, for case of current, I am going to collect the magnitude and the phase, and now I am going to use the well define complex numbers. So to use phasor, we notice that suppose if I want to calculate this I star, then I can also write like this, and this is obvious from the complex manipulation of complex number. And I can also write like this Vm Im cos theta V and theta I plus j sin theta V minus theta I. So just you can assume that this particular quantity half V I star that I have defined like this, and that can be expressed like this. So now if you are willing to define the average power that I am telling P, so P is the half of the real part of this particular quantity, half of the real part of this quantity. So I have done some mistake in writing. Okay, I have to select eraser. I think I have some problem. So this is the half, and after that I have the real part of V I star, and that is nothing but half into Vm Im cos theta V minus theta. So in this way I can express the average power in the frequency domain. And now you can see that whenever I have to calculate the average power, then I express quantity in form of phasor, and after that we will just multiply the magnitude and multiplied with cos theta V minus theta I. So let us now consider some special cases. So I am going to consider the special cases. So basically first special case, when I have theta V equal to theta I. So if I have when theta V equal to theta I, in this case the voltage and current are in phase whenever this kind of situation. So we have already know what is meaning of in phase. This implies a purely resistive network. This also we have analyzed. Circuit. So basically average power P is half Vm Im, and I can also write like this, half Im square R or half I square R. Here I square is I star. Now let us try to see the second special case, that is when theta V minus theta I, that is equal to plus minus 90 degree, we have a purely reactive circuit. It means that circuit either contain inductor or capacitor circuit. And in this situation, if you calculate the average power, that is half Vm Im and cos 90 degree of this equal to 0. So basically this result is showing that a purely reactive circuit absorb no average power. That is the conclusion. Average power. So let us now come to the summary of today's class. So basically now I am talking about the summary. So a resistive load R absorb powers, because we have already seen that what is meaning of absorption means absorption of power. If power is positive, then we are interpreting like this: at all time while a reactive load, that is L or C, absorbs zero average. That is the conclusion, or that is the summary. Now, before closing the today's class, I am going to talk about one numerical example. So let us try to talk about one numerical example. Almost all numerical example is straightforward. So problem is like this. for the circuit shown in figure. I am going to draw the circuit. Find the average power supplied by the source and the average power absorbed by the resistor. So let us draw the circuit. So suppose that our circuit is like this. So I have one AC voltage source. So magnitude of that voltage source is 5 and phase angle is 30 degree this volt, and I have one resistor and I have one capacitor. So this is RC circuit in phasor domain, 2 ohm, this is 4 ohm, and suppose that I have this current I, and after that I have to calculate the average power. So let us talk about the solution. So the current I is given by I is nothing but 530 by, just you can apply the KVL J2, and if you manipulate this complex number then you are going to get this. Please check it, 5, 6, 5. So this much current is going to flow through this network, and now I have to calculate the average power supplied by the voltage source, and this average power is P equal to 1/2, and magnitude of voltage source is 5 and magnitude of this is like this, cos phase difference between these two. And if you calculate this number then that is 2.5 watt. And if you observe the current through the resistor, that is same like circuit current. So now I can calculate the voltage across resistor, that is 4 into IR, so that is 4.472, 56.57 degree. So voltage and current both are in phase, so I can calculate the average power. So P average is 1/2, 4.472 multiplied by 1.118 and 2.5 watt. So you can see here in this particular example also, whatever power that is going to supply by the source, voltage source, that is exactly equal to the power absorbed by the resistor. And zero average power is absorbed by the capacitor. This is the calculation. Also confirms the story. So with this discussion, I am going to close the today's class. Thank you very much.